My name's Nicholas Clark, creator of Fatherless Britain. I've come over here this morning as me and my boy just to come over here and knock a bowl around. Have a little chat, if you like. I've not seen either of them now for 4 years. Last time I saw them was in May 2017 when I took them to school as usual, dropped them at school. My family court case was heard in May 2018. I was told at the beginning of the court case that if I made any more videos or published anything pertaining to my family court case, that I'd be locked up. The clip that you're about to see is taken from Dispatches, which was aired last week, Tuesday, 20th of July 2021. The reporter, Louise Tickle, she confirms the fact of what I'm telling you now, that it's actually illegal to report anything that goes on within the family court. And by doing so, I'm risking my liberty potentially being locked up.
There is chronic underfunding of family justice. There are too few judges and more parents are going to court. The system is overrun and overstretched. But by default, anything that goes wrong in the family courts happens in secret. It's a criminal offence to report what has happened in court. And if no one can ever know the specifics of the problems, they can't be fixed.
What is the solution to this problem?
Well, we've got to open the courts up. If a journalist comes across a transcript where a judge has behaved appallingly, what on earth is the justification for saying that you can't report a judge's misbehaviour if it's confined to the judge himself? And it's indefensible that journalists cannot do that.
The family court needs a major overhaul. That secrecy is actually enabling abusers. And so it's really important that we sort of lift the lid off the family courts and we actually understand the court decisions that are made.
If family courts were held in public, what do you think people would think of them?
I think that they would be shocked by some of the things that they see and hear, particularly from judges.
Something profoundly wrong is going on. There is no oversight. You've got the fox guarding the hen house. The laws need to change.
That episode of Dispatches was called Torn Apart by the Family Courts. As I say, the last time I saw my boys was when I dropped into school in May 2017. When I went to pick them up at school that afternoon, I received a text message from my ex saying that she's taking the boys. And that was last, you know, that was last I saw. At the beginning of the court hearing in May 2018, I requested a delay, postponement, as I hadn't been supplied with a hard copy of the what's known as the court bundle. The court bundle is all of the legal documents, all of the arguments that are going to be heard within the case, so to speak. My ex's legal counsel rebutted this straight away. And he said that he delivered the court bundle via email a few days ago. And I could have printed it off, and downloaded it and printed it off. His exact words. He delivered them a few days ago. I could have downloaded it and printed it off. Now we're talking of a 400-page document, legal documents, pertaining to my children and whether I'm going to see them again, etc., and all that goes with it. Immediately, the judge, she turned around and said, the case will continue. At that point, by the judge doing that, knowing that I haven't got a hard copy of the court bundle, she's just committed what's known as a denial fraud. As I don't have, if you like, all of the tools, I don't have a court bundle, I don't have the documents in order to represent myself fairly or appropriately, so to speak, in any which way, shape or form. When I got home that day, at the end of the first day of the hearing, there was a recorded delivery card on the doormat. They'd posted the hard copy of the court bundle the 2 days, the afternoon, 2 days before the court hearing. So, yeah, 2 days, day and a half. You've just heard that it's actually illegal to report anything that goes on within the family court here, family court. Now, the fact that the judge committed that denial fraud, as well as many other frauds and that I've experienced throughout this whole procedure, it means that I'm automatically entitled to what's called the protection of the Crown. So then, yes, they can legally, so to speak, do I use the term, lock me up. But there's the clause of the fact that they've committed denial frauds and propagated misinformation all the way through. So I'm entitled to the protection of the Crown. I have actually approached my local MP. To be honest, he's just not interested. Never has been, actually. So, I've got no choice, really, but to do what I'm doing, go public. As I've got no other options. There's nothing. There's nowhere else for me to go. There's no other opportunity. You also heard that Sir James Munby, who was appointed by the Queen, the head of the president of the family division in 2013, I think it was. And he's saying that the family courts need to be opened up. This is Nicholas Clark, Fatherless Britain. Thank you.